You asked and you shall receive. Today I'm going to talk about how I EQ my audio, my YouTube talking head audio, this voice right here that I'm doing right now. Yeah, let's get it. So here's my mission today, guys. I'm going to simplify this thing as much as possible, and hopefully it's going to help you and your content. Let's start with a before and after. Before, if you guys got any value from this video, subscribe and check out these other videos for Final Cut Pro users. And I will see you guys in the next one. Hopefully. Peace. And after. If you guys got any value from this video, subscribe and check out these other videos for Final Cut Pro users. And I will see you guys in the next one. Hopefully. Peace. Okay, guys, straight from the camera, from the recorder, I put the equalization to loudness. Then I add this new and updated voice isolation right here. But of course, if you use that, as always, don't overdo it. I just choose to have mine around 70 to 80%. I think it works best for my setting. The bottom line is that there is no formula to this, guys. Of course, there are some technical theories, but this video, it's not about that. Then after that, I add the compressor effect to even up the levels of my audio. I just leave it at the default preset. And if you noticed, up to this point, I'm just adding these effects without really tweaking them. Then I add a limiter set around minus 6 dB. So that the audio gain will not pass that threshold. Again, keeping it simple, guys, keeping it simple. Of course, you can tweak all these effects, but these small changes will do for this video. And after all that, that's when I apply the channel EQ effect. And it looks like this. There are about, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 frequency points on this line. They have different colors up here. And what you need to know is that from the left side to the right, you go from the low frequencies to the high frequencies. And because human conversational voices usually ranges between here, 80 to about 180 for an adult man, and 165 to about maybe somewhere here, 255 or for a woman. So we don't really need this extremity. So just click on both sides. And that will automatically create these points, and it will lower them too at the same time. The next step is very simple. We just reduce the frequency of the sound that we don't like and add more to the ones that we like. Pretty simple, right? So click on Analyze. Because if you click on Analyze, you can actually see these frequency waves. You listen to the audio and you see these frequency waves. And then just choose any of the frequency point. But we're gonna make this range smaller so that we can really isolate the frequency we're working on. So click here and then drag into the middle, or just go here and then drag down, and this number will get smaller. That will also do the same thing. Let's play the audio. Really, we can drag this point up and listen if there's anything we don't like. If you guys got any value from this video, subscribe and check out these other videos for Final Cut Pro users. And I will see you guys in the next one. Hopefully. Peace. Okay, right here, we're going to just drag this down. Again, everything you do, don't overdo it, because it will sound over process, and then you can repeat that process until you're satisfied. On the other hand, if you hear something you like, make this a little larger and drag it up. There you go. And just try to really get something that you like, that you feel that sounds nice. I saved my effects for these settings so that I can use it anytime I am doing a YouTube video. And look at that, look at how I called it. Use this, yes. Let me show you how my channel EQ looks like. That's it. If you guys got any value from this video, subscribe and check out these other videos for Final Cut Pro users. And I will see you guys in the next one. Hopefully. Peace.